Hello, my name is Susan Rushton, and welcome to my show, Olio. Before I go any further, I need, as always, to explain what Olio means. It's a Spanish-Portuguese dish, and it's short for olla podrida. This dish has everything in the world in it. Pork in all its iterations, anything you can imagine with pork, that pork is made of pork or comes from a pig, that's what's in olla podrida. And it also has chicken, chickpeas, spinach, cabbage, carrots, beans, garlic, onions, as I said, everything in the world in it except oatmeal and popcorn. That's one definition. Olio is also what comes in between acts of a melodrama. So you might have somebody juggling, you might have somebody singing, you might have somebody doing a skit, and none of it has anything to do with anything else, and none of it has anything to do with the melodrama. So in other words, it's apples, oranges, and a monkey wrench. Welcome to my monkey wrench. Today, my guests are two visionaries in the Auburn area. These are Trudy Harris and Cynthia Woods from Team Giving. Ladies, thank you very much for joining me, coming here. And I need to know, you can speak at once if you like or not, but what's Team Giving?
Well, Team Giving is a nonprofit here in the Northern California area. And what we do is we work with nonprofits in the community and match them up with volunteers. So we meet with the nonprofits, we find out what kind of projects or ongoing activities they need help with, and then we actively go and seek volunteers to help them out. So it's really kind of, our computer person calls us the match.com of volunteer work.
Match.com of volunteer work.
We just match people up, so, yeah.
And Trudy, you are a chief community officer? What does that mean?
Yeah, well, Cynthia and I co-founded Team Giving together, and so it's a fantastic partnership. She's the CEO. We call me the CCO just because I go out in the community a lot and meet with different groups and do presentations.
So you've done this sort of thing before?
It's kind of...
over and over.
Yes, lots.
And that's what it takes, isn't it?
Absolutely. It's really the networking, and we do a lot of networking. Both of us spend a lot of time meeting with people, talking with people, finding out what they need, reevaluating volunteer needs at different times, because it shifts, you know, for seasons and different events that are going on, the needs shift for every nonprofit. Like the holidays, we really had a wonderful holiday experience. It was incredible. We were like, oh my goodness, what are we going to do? We need all these volunteers, and we managed to get most of them and had a fantastic holiday season, but it was just unbelievable what the nonprofits do in the community. So now we know. Going into next year, we're going to gear up for it. So
just unbelievable. Yeah. No, it isn't. Yeah. It's amazing.
Yes.
I'm impressed by this whole idea of match.com for volunteers. What caught you? Why did you start this?
Both Trudy and I worked for the Boys and Girls Club, Placer County. Trudy for 5 years and me for 10. And we saw a need. It was really Trudy's idea, but we saw a need where people would want to volunteer for that organization, and when they'd call, it would be really difficult for us to try to come up with projects and coordinate because everybody's wearing so many hats, everyone's so busy. Mm-hmm. So we thought we could be the coordinators, the facilitators to help bring
for the Boys and Girls Club.
Well, for a nonprofit organization.
Okay. In general.
We both were working. I was doing marketing and admin.
Excuse me, nonprofit organizations kept calling.
Businesses, like for example, Kohl's called and they had a number of volunteers and they wanted to come out and do a project for the Boys and Girls Club. And nobody was able to coordinate it. Mm. Everyone was so busy doing all these other things.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
So
I understand.
The idea was born out of that type of thing happening. And so we brought our idea to a foundation, somebody that we know, and she absolutely loved the idea. And we wrote a grant, and they accepted us, and they awarded us funding to get started.
Yeah, and very so, lucky, very fortunate.
Yes.
Good.
And so now we're in our second year, and they've agreed to support us for a couple more years, but we're starting to do a lot of grant writing. So I'm in the office a lot more than Trudy. doing marketing and a lot of data.
A lot of emailing, a lot of phoning, a lot of writing letters elegantly.
And Trudy's been amazing at getting the word out there about us. She goes to a lot of Rotaries. We joined four chambers, Sacramento, Rockland, Roseville, and Auburn. Mm-hmm. So we do a lot of events. We get out there so we can meet businesses and nonprofits.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah,
go ahead.
I was going to say it's real important to let people know because we currently don't charge any fees for our services. We do this as a service for the community because it was real important to us to be able to do that. So we want to let the businesses know that, you know, they can contact us, and we've actually had this happen and say, I've got 25 employees. I want to do a team community giving day on this date or this time period. Can you find us something? And we've actually set up several events like that. From companies as large as Intel to smaller companies, family-owned companies. We've found them a project, got it coordinated. Cynthia does these gorgeous sign-up sheets that she emails so that people can send those out. All the instructions, we work with the nonprofits. So all they have to do is show up. And the Intel Day, for example, was wonderful because we had a whole group of Intel engineers and computer people out at the Prairie City ATV Park building birdhouses for the Habitat program. So they're out there just hammering and nailing and putting together these hawk houses and stuff like that, and they had an absolute wonderful time. And the park was so grateful for their help. So we actually were able to match up two people that wouldn't necessarily have connected otherwise. So that's kind of another thing that's come out of this, is we're realizing we're creating these partnerships that wouldn't necessarily have found each other on their own. So we can help guide that.
Now, I have, say there's, hypothetically, there is a nonprofit organization or a nonprofit group that has lots of members, and the nonprofit group calls you to bring volunteers into this, to help this organization. Why is that not, isn't that what the nonprofit organization is supposed to do?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. But a lot of times there are volunteer coordinators who actually, that's their title, but they wear so many hats that a lot of times it's difficult to fulfill all their volunteer needs. And the easier we make it for nonprofits, the easier it is for them to fulfill their mission. And it's more cost effective because the more volunteers they can use, the less money they have to spend on salaries.
Right.
So in some instances, we're finding volunteers for ongoing positions at nonprofits.
Yeah.
You're finding volunteers for ongoing positions at nonprofits.
Right. Like, for example, if you wanted a volunteer to come help with your show on a weekly basis, somebody would volunteer their time on a weekly basis, we could help coordinate that. So they would come repeatedly. So that would be an ongoing thing.
Okay.
So we could help coordinate it and set it up, get them here working with you, and then our hope is, and this is actually happening, it's been real exciting, is that people start to volunteer for a group and they fall in love with it or they find their passion and they stay with them. Like, we've got groups that are now going back on their own or saying, what else can I do? Because they've been exposed to this nonprofit and seeing the value of what they do for the community. So, you know, our hope is that eventually the volunteers we have now will be connected up on their own and doing their thing, and we'll have a whole new group of volunteers to match up with the different organizations. So it's making those connections.
So, for example, I run Silver Screen Classic Movie Series the first Saturday of the month at the Auburn Library.
Plug.
The movie's free, but I'd be delighted to sell you popcorn. I have three shows. Sometimes I have trouble finding enough people to make popcorn. I need three people per show.
Okay.
If I contact you, you would find somebody to come in and help me make popcorn?
We would do our best.
Yes. You know, we would absolutely do our best.
We never promise because, you know, things happen, things come up.
Right.
But we're pretty good at finding volunteers.
Yeah.
So, yeah, you would just tell us a need. Say, I need three people on a Saturday from 3 to 6 to make popcorn. And that's what we put on our website. We have a volunteer page, and on that volunteer page, we have a listing of one-time opportunities, which is usually special events, golf tournaments, mm-hmm. crab feeds, that type of thing. And then ongoing opportunities like Cynthia was talking about. And then we also have special projects. And those usually entail a little bit more people power, sometimes a little bit of maybe a grant, you know, a small amount of money needed for materials.
More coordination.
More coordination. It's building shelving units or that type of thing. It's, you know, it has to do with those type of functions.
And muscle.
Sometimes.
Okay. Yeah. That's building something.
Yeah.
That takes more thinking and skill and patience.
We're very unique, because there are some other organizations that do what we do, but we're very hands-on. Mm-hmm. So we actually, if somebody signs up on our website and wants to volunteer for a project that we have listed there, we contact them immediately and we help coordinate that. They don't just sign up and then have to show up somewhere. You know, we're there to let them know that we know they've signed up and we're coordinating everything. Also,
so you do the thinking.
Yes.
You do the
planning. All the planning and mm-hmm. the work. And it's really helpful for nonprofits, you know, who especially are having trouble finding volunteers. Uh-huh. Another really good thing that we've done is we've started making connections with nonprofits to nonprofits. So, for example, this Saturday, Quinonia Home for Teens, the teens, I think about 30 of them, are going to be going up to Camp Ross Relis to help clean the camp, get it ready for the season. So we're making that connection, and hopefully if they have a great time, they'll do it every year.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a really good thing for the kids to be doing community service and giving back.
And going someplace.
Although it might rain this weekend, but there's still going to be work to do, even if there's rain. And then the camp is just so excited to have them come up and help. So.
And the beauty of that is the camp is open to the public for retreats and stuff, but in August they have 3 or 4 weeks of camp for underprivileged children. So it's actually the teens from Konya giving back to the kids that are in need. So it's really a full circle.
Wow.
Yeah, and that was...
It's pretty special.
Yeah, we're actually really excited about that.
So. And it's clear you're excited. The word is getting out.
I think so.
Slowly. There's no other way to get it out except to slowly in word of mouth and this sort of thing and the radio show, the Newcastle radio show, which you did with John and Robin. And you have helped AAUW. You've promoted yourself at AAUW at an AAUW meeting last year. By the way, this is 2017, and so April 4th of 2017, and so you are, while I'm thinking about it, coming up in May 13th of 2017, this is the third annual Community Service Day.
It's the Auburn Community Service Day.
Yeah.
It's in Auburn.
Yeah. Auburn Community Service
it's
Day
in Auburn.
And you're coordinating it.
We were asked to work on the committee with Renee Berg from Visit Auburn mm-hmm. and Cheryl Peterson mm-hmm. from ARD.
Yes.
Then there's other committee members that are working on it. And our role is actually to help coordinate and make sure we get enough volunteers. And so if people want to volunteer for that day, there's several projects that still need volunteers. They can go to auburncommunityserviceday.com.
auburncommunityserviceday.com.
Yes.
Okay. Is there a link to auburncommunityserviceday.com at teamgiving.org?
Yes. On our website, so if you go to auburncommunityserviceday.com, it'll link you to our website.
Okay.
And on our events page, there's actually a page for that event, and then the jobs are all listed on that page.
So. Okay.
Yeah.
And while we're there, I have this phone number. Is this 1-916? Or 916 from Auburn?
Just 916.
916. 916-824-2118. And email is info@teamgiving.org. Is this info@teamgiving.org? Is this what you expected to happen?
not.
It's crazy.
It's funny because we were looking over some information we'd pulled together for our proposal to submit in October for our second year grant. And we had targeted ourselves, I think, to do, 1,400 hours in 2016. And we thought, wow, if we can hit that. Well, we blew that out of the water. We did 1,800. We're over 2,200 hours
now.
Right. Volunteer hours that we've coordinated with over 480 volunteers. All over the community.
40 nonprofits.
Yeah, 40 nonprofits and about 38 businesses. So what we're finding is there's a real need for this. The businesses want to help. The nonprofits need the help, but there was no coordinated path, and that's what we've really developed, is just a simple way. You know, someone can call us and say, I've got two young kids, and I want to go out and do something in the wilderness and volunteer projects. What do you have? And we can go through our list
Here,
of jobs that we
I have. This and this
exactly.
and this and this.
Yeah.
And by the way, I want to help somebody do something. I want to help somebody learn how to cook,
right?
For example.
Yeah.
Well, we have this too. Okay.
And we're working on adding a family-friendly page so that for parents who want to take their kids out to volunteer, to have ideas for them and places for them to look.
Yeah, because so there actually is a lot out there. But, you know, because we check when we meet with the nonprofits, we find out what kind of volunteer needs they have. And then we also find out what the perimeters are. They required to get life scan or something like that? If they're working with kids on a long-term basis, yes. If it's a one-time thing, probably not. But some of them have age restrictions for safety reasons and stuff like that. So we get all that information. So that's the other thing I think that's really helpful, is when someone contacts us about volunteering, they don't have to kind of sift through, well, I'd like to do that. Oh, I can't. I'd like to do that. Or, oh, my kids can't come. We can tell them right away, okay, that sounds great, but they only take kids over 14. Mm-hmm. And then they can kind of plan accordingly. So it's another way we try and make it just really easy to volunteer. You know, that's the thing. If it's easy, people will do it. And once they do it, they fall in love with it. You know, it becomes part of your life.
Another story is, for example, AAA in Roseville. They called us. I think we did an e-blast at the Roseville Chamber, so they found out about us, and they called us, and they had been having a terrible time finding where they could volunteer. They have 24 hours a year per employee that they can volunteer on company time, and they have specific times, 10 to 12,
the two middle weeks of the month.
In the two middle weeks of the month, 10 to 12, and they wanted to stay in Roseville, and we've since connected them with five different nonprofits that they volunteered for. And we're hoping that they'll go back to those same nonprofits and create relationships for volunteering. So they're really happy with us, and we're so happy that we could help them.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, and they ran into exactly what kind of fired us to get to do this was, you know, the lady had been calling different nonprofits. She wasn't getting calls back because the nonprofit person who's in charge of the volunteers is also making sure the kids are fed and helping with homework and paying the bills and everything else. So it was just that frustration.
And finding the time to coordinate. Oh, some volunteers want to come on Wednesday from 10 to 12. Well, what do I have them do?
Right.
So we're doing all that legwork, and then we're coordinating it and helping people find those places to go to.
And so, to clarify, if nobody's heard about this, if they need volunteers, they don't pay you to find them.
Not currently.
Nobody pays us.
And you're hoping to have that be true forever in perpetuity. You're always, in addition to looking for nonprofits and looking for volunteers, you're working on getting grants.
Yes. We're hoping that other foundations and maybe businesses will see the value in the work that we're doing and want to support us so that we can continue helping make connections for people, for nonprofits and businesses and individuals. So that's the hope.
How does one prepare for doing this?
You just jump in with a big leap of faith and a lot of...
What a good idea. Let's do it.
Yeah, that's about what
that's about.
Trudy had the idea for probably several years, and she told me about it many times. And once I mentioned it to a person that we know, and then we got connected with the foundation, it was like we couldn't turn back because they said, we want to do this with you, and so we just decided we're going to...
And
we're
this is a this the foundation doesn't want to be public.
Not
it's
particularly.
A private foundation.
Yeah, it's a private foundation.
Okay.
They saw the value in what we wanted to do. They could see that the connections that could be made could just continue to grow and grow and grow, and that's what's starting to happen. We're working with Safe Credit Union, and the Sac State, the athletic departments, two larger groups, and we were at a career fair last night. And I was so, it was so wonderful for us because several students came up and go, oh yeah, you guys coordinated the volunteering I did this last weekend. And they were excited. They were excited to meet us and be part of it. And oh yeah, I'll sign up, send me all the stuff. So we're actually getting young people excited about doing it. We're getting it Safe Credit Union. She sends an email out and she gets, you know, 8-10 signups for the Stamp Out Hunger that's going on down in Sacramento when the mailmen pick up all the food that day. So it's just kind of creating this culture of giving. And that's what just makes me
when I first learned about you, I thought, I have all these things that where I need volunteers, and it's so hard to get volunteers, like pulling teeth, but people want to do this.
They do.
They just don't know what all the options are.
Tell me what to do.
Right. Yeah. We have one lady who's a very good friend of ours. We worked with her at the Boys and Girls Club, and she actually volunteers on her own now for an international refugee foundation in Sacramento. But she travels a lot. She's got a new grandchild in the Bay Area. So she really can't make a long-term commitment, like be there every week type thing. She loves it. When she's in town, we call her and say, hey, you want to go do this? And she goes, sounds great. And she shows up and does it, so she gets to give, you know, on what works really good with her schedule, and she's staying connected in that volunteer world, but she's not feeling like, oh, I got to call him and tell him I can't come this week, or I'm going to be gone for a month, or something like that. So we're finding that people that just have occasional opportunities really like the fact that they can just go do something, help a group, you know, have a great afternoon, and then go on to whatever else they're doing.
Okay. So this is teamgiving.org. 916-824-2118, info@teamgiving.org. So this is 2017, and again, May 13th, we have the third annual Auburn Community Service Day. Mm-hmm.
And then we have our event.
And your event on April 27th, 2017. So what is this thing going on April 27th?
Well, it's our first annual volunteer celebration. We just wanted to really have a chance to get our volunteers, people from the community, the nonprofits, and just everybody who's worked and supported, you know, worked with us and supported us through the year, get them together and say thank you. Okay, thank you to these wonderful people that step up and do these incredible things.
And if people haven't volunteered for you,
they can come anyway.
They can come anyway. Celebrate
the giving. Yeah.
The theme is the magic of volunteers. Yeah. We're going to have a magician there. We also are going to have music by some students from Bach to Rock or Rock to Bach.
I can't remember which.
I don't know if it matters much.
Yeah. No,
but they would insist
our,
it does.
Our MCs are from Stutter Street Theater. We've done some volunteering with them, and so they're coming to volunteer at our event. So it should be really fun.
Yeah.
Now, where is this?
It's going to be at the Blue Goose in Loomis.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
right there on Taylor Road. Yes. Starts at 5:30 on the 27th, and we will have some refreshments, and we just invite everybody to come and celebrate the community. It really is a celebration of the community.
And it is a fundraiser, too. We have a raffle and an auction.
We'll have a little
and a no-host bar.
Right.
So it's a little bit of a fundraiser, but a celebration, too.
Yeah.
I want to put in a plug here for companies, groups, businesses. Thank you for providing raffle prizes for events like this. I am just enthralled and gratified by I live here. I'm part of this community. I see this all the time. And granted, I understand that it's a way to get the word out about yourself and your organization, your business. But it's so kind.
Yes.
it's just a great way of doing that.
Yeah.
Every event I go to has a raffle, and people are thrilled. In my awareness, people are thrilled to have raffles.
Right.
Yeah, they're fun.
Yeah.
Whenever I sign up for a silent auction item, I always tell my husband if I get it, I say, I won. And he's
sure.
We had to pay for it.
Right.
I didn't win anything.
Yeah,
but it's
I won.
Just fun.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
That's fun.
Yeah, and we're actually at our event too. We have some wonderful people donating different items for our raffle and silent auction. And we're actually going to have a table where they can put some information about their business and acknowledging the in-kind donations, because those are just as important as the financial.
Absolutely, yes.
You know, we've got some really, really generous people doing some incredible things.
Yes, so, like, yeah. For example, here are two of them.
Well, thank you.
Thank you very much.
So May 13th, the Auburn Community Service Day, the third annual of one of those, of that. Find out more about it at teamgiving.org or the auburncommunityserviceday.com.
Right.
And April 27th at the Blue Goose, what day is that?
It's a Thursday, yeah.
Thursday.
It starts at 5:30-ish. You know, we realize we've got to get off work.
April 27th at the Blue Goose in Loomis. Mm-hmm. I love that place.
I know. It's a fantastic place.
Oh, okay.
It's a good place for a party.
Yeah, it is.
Why do people want to volunteer?
Volunteering makes you feel good. If you're doing something meaningful and you have a good experience, you walk away just kind of on a high, I think. Mm-hmm. And I think for young people, it's really good for them to volunteer because they can learn a new skill, they can get job experience through volunteering, and it's good for their resume. It's really beneficial to anyone in the community. When businesses go out and volunteer together, I think it's really good because they're doing something together outside of the work environment. Sort of like team building. Mm-hmm. But
yeah. Well, and they actually just finished a study at, I think it was Harvard. It was one of the Ivy League schools. Mm-hmm. They did a 10-year study about people who volunteered and people who didn't. And they really followed and tracked how they did. They were healthier, they were more active, they had better social connections, they had stronger family ties, they were living longer, they were more interested, they were more informed. So it's just I've been to different volunteer events even before this when I was just volunteering, and all of a sudden you find out you're loading clothes into baskets next to the city council member for that city, and then mm-hmm. you've got the vice mayors over there, and you've got this person, and you just make these incredible connections, and some of them become lifelong friends.
Yes.
You know, it's really, yeah. And then, you know, the bottom line is when you see those kids pick up their Christmas toys at the Salvation Army or that,
sure.
or that you get blessed for the 20th time when you serve Easter dinner at a homeless shelter,
yes.
you go home, like she said, you're on a high.
Yeah.
You're like, this is the best thing in the world.
Yes.
So we want everybody to experience that.
Yeah.
You know, and have
wow.
that in their life.
And I have read several letters to the editor saying, I wanted to volunteer, but I couldn't find anybody. I couldn't find any place that needed me. Or, well, you know, it's not like looking under rocks. There are places and organizations that need volunteers that... Mm-hmm. that value volunteers, and here are two people, two really...
willing to help.
Yeah, we'll help you.
Yes, yeah. Yes, man.
Well, and like Cynthia said, the example that kind of brought this home when we worked at the club is we got a call from Kohl's one day, and they had 5 employees for 5 hours, that's 25 people hours, and they were going to give us money. So it was like, this is amazing.
Win-win.
Well, Cynthia was in the middle of getting stuff ready for a golf tournament. We were both working on that. Our program director was handling the transition of the kids from summer camp to the school year, which is a challenge. And everybody was completely maxed out. And by the time I called Kohl's back a week and a half later, they'd already found somebody.
Oh.
So it wasn't
at
true,
least they
you
found
know,
somebody.
It was like,
yeah. Yes.
Oh, yeah. You know. But that's the kind of thing I tell people if they're trying to volunteer and they've contacted a nonprofit, you know, call us. We can contact them or find out. That's what we're here for. Because it's not that the nonprofit doesn't want the help. They want the help. They need the help.
Right.
They just they look at the stack of messages and go, okay,
mm-hmm.
I can make it this far.
Yeah.
So
okay. So Trudy Harris and Cynthia Woods of Team Giving. Thank you very much for joining me. This has been fabulous, a wonderful conversation. Thank you.
Okay.
If you want to learn more, and you should, please contact teamgiving.org. Call them 916-824-2118 or email info@teamgiving.org. A great place to go if you want to volunteer. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you again.